connectivity issues at our side. So that's why there was some delay here. We have come to the third session of today. That is on we have with us experts, Mr. Anurag Chaudhary and Mr. Chandan. They are actually our ME students, but they have worked a lot on robotics and embedded system. And today they will be sharing their experiences with you on the various interfacing of sensors with the embedded system. They have also brought one robot with them based on Arduino, which they will be demonstrating to you. It will be, I'm sure, very interesting lecture. And please try to ask questions also from them and get as much as possible. Over to both of you.
Thank you, ma'am. Good afternoon to all the participants, teachers, and who are connected with us. So today we are going to start real-time interfacing of 8051 and Arduino-based project. And we are also make the some project Arduino-based and some interfacing, real-time interfacing of LCD and some other sensors are there. So we are starting my PPT on the first of all, we discuss some basics about sensors. Okay, or I'm also grateful to Dr. Ritula Thakur to give me this opportunity to share some knowledge of real-time interfacing of Arduino and 8051 microcontroller. So we are going to start the real-time interfacing. Real-time interfacing. Okay, so these in my PPT also, they all are the sensors which are available. I'll show you the all sensor in the hardware part. So this one is a LDR sensor. I show the working, what is the LDR. Okay, this is the LDR and this is IR sensor are there, potentiometer and the flex sensor. And I also told the all the working and the applications, how can you make a smart robotics applications and other robotic arm applications. Okay, this is the PIR sensor and this is the ultrasonic sensor. Okay, so this is my development kit. Okay, this is my development board. This many type of development board available in the market. This one is a one type of development board are there, and some other type AVR type board are there. This is the AVR type board because we need some crystal. We need some crystal and switches and some two capacitors are there to making the programming of the 8051. Okay, so this is the many type of controller available in the market. Board. Okay, so and it have many in this kit, it have four matrix keypad also at and the 8-bit LED are there, ISP connections for the programming of the 8051. And this one is a 8051 microcontroller. And in the, if talk about the hardware, this one is a 805 microcontroller. So it is put in the kit. And also the 7-segment display are there. And this one is a 7805 voltage regulator, because we need the 5-volt signal to the controlling signal. Okay, and the power supply will be 9-volt or 12-volt to converting the 5-volt. We using this voltage regulator. Okay, this is the display selector, and the many other options are there. The LCD holder. This is the LCD. We are connected LCD here, and this is the A2D converter IC, because we take the analog signal from the sensors. Some signal are digital, but most of the signal are analog. So we use enough 8051 to convert analog signal into digital signal. Okay, this is the external internal switches are there. Reset button is there. And this one is the RTC real time counter. Okay, this one, this is the real time IC. So this is DB9 female connector to show the monitor and connected with your some monitor also display. And these are all the output devices. Means you take the input from the sensors and controlling the motors, relay, display. You can display your data, 7 display segment. This is the relay. This is the stepper motor. And in the application for the robotics arm, we use some stepper motors to controlling the all motors in robotic arms. Okay, so first we going to discuss the some sensors. So this is the sensor. First sensor is the LDR, and I also show the interfacing with the 8051 both and Arduino also. So this is the sensor LDR. It is a light dependent sensor. So what when the light fall on the surface of the LDR, it changes the resistance. Okay, when the resistance will change, the this depend on, totally depend on the light. How many light fall on the surface, the resistance will be vary. Okay, so it is also called the photoresistor. And the next is IR based sensor. Actually, it is an object detector sensor. In the figure, this one is a photodiode. This is a simple LED. This is transmitter and this is the receiver. Okay, when the some object will be detect, he fall is through the ray coming, and this one is a receiver. The ray will be received by the photo diode. Okay, the range is adjustable. This one is a variable, means you can measure the distance. How can you use the most distance? Okay, so you can, this is the adjustable range, and it is operating of the 5 volt DC, and the sensitive up to 30 cm. Okay, and it is based on the digital logic. I also told the signal are, input signal are two types, analog signal and the digital signal. So from this sensor we take the analog signal also and the digital signal also. Okay, so these are the okay, it have a three pins. One is a 5 volt providing, and the second one is a ground, and third one is a digital input. Okay, so this digital input connected with the 8051 some pin P.0 means which you want, and in the Arduino also you can connect the digital point 10 to 13 pin you have there. Okay, so there are many application in the industry for the automatic door open and the robotic applications, object detector, and there are many application in industry also. And we are going to other sensor. This is my ultrasonic sensor. It is measure the distance to count, means how to how much distance are there. So ultrasonic sensor model has a two transducer, one for the transmit and other for the receiver. Both are fixed on the PCB. You see in the figure, this one is a transmitter and this one is a receiver. It transmits the signal and it receives the signal. How many time it take? So it calculate the distance. What is the distance between the object and the sensor? Okay, and the ultrasonic sensor provide precise non-contact distance, and its range 2 cm to 400 cm also. Okay, so there I also connected with the some circuits. You see later, and this is the most important sensor. It's a very useful sensor to making some robotics arms, and you also control with the, by this sensor from your hand to control the all the appliance, electrical and the motor also. You connected and printing the for the dumb pupil. I show you that demonstration. Oh, I make a make a model for the dumb students. You have not to, means not clearly say to some what he want. So he using the fingers. It is a when we are tilt the sensors, it change the its resistance. Just like the LDR change the resistance when the light is fall on the LDR. So it's vary the resistance. So it's when is bending, so it's change the resistance. This one is a LDR, this one is a flex sensor, and when it tilt, this one is, suppose this is tilt, so it's vary the resistance. I show you the demonstration also, and this sensor can flexing or bending in the one direction. If we move in the other direction, it not be changed. It is a fixed. Okay, it's work only the one direction only. And these sensor are easy to use. They are basically register that change the value based on how much they fixed. And if they unflexed, the resistance is about 10k. Okay, and when we connected in the circuit, so we use the 10k resistor with this, because we are making a voltage divider circuit, and what will voltage change by the this and calculate and go to the microcontroller. And this one is a LCD. okay, so here LCD is connected to the Arduino also and the microcontroller. I show you the how connected with the and how to program with the LCD, then some program print on the LCD also. So LCD have a 16 pin. First we discuss about LED some basics. So it have a 16 pin. So 8 pin will dedicated to the data. Means LED is used for 4 bit data and the 8 bit data also. We depend on the data, how much data we print on the LCD. So it have the 16 pin, 8 pin dedicated for the data, pin number 16, pin number 7 to 14 we dedicated to the data. First pin number, first it's a ground pin, And the second pin is supply 5 volt supply give to the second pin VCC, and the VVE pin is voltage enable pin. It enable the LED. So we are grounding this pin. RS is a register select, read and write pin, and this is also enable pin. Okay, these pins are also contrast control of the LCD. Okay, so now these are the connections. How can connect the LCD? You can demonstrate. Okay, so I demonstrate also. I make some program to display the data. Connect the wire. Okay, you see in the video also the print Nital Chandigarh, the 1 byte data will be provided byte by byte. So one letter in N, I, T, 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 it's take some delay. So I provide in the delay program, 1 second means 1 millisecond program delay. So it's coming in. This is the program you see. This is the program I make. So in the program I use as a port 0 as a data. Okay, and you can see in the connected the port 0 use as a data, and the enable pin, pin number 4 and the pin number 6 register select pin, these are connected to the port 2. You can see Nital Chandigarh thoda print dikha raha hu. Okay, this is the Nital Chandigarh is printed. Okay, and Ritula ma'am is also told you about the how can make a hex file and how to burn. I also show you the how to man a file, because of we in this laptop we have no kill software, so that's why I'm not show you.
We've already been discussed.
Okay, so Ritula ma'am is already discussed.
Hex file
conversion
is done.
Okay.
Okay. Hmm.
It have a, it is a universal burner. If you any kit are not working, you take your microcontroller and fix it in this, and you make a hex file to connect it this wire. Okay, and it use the Wheeler programmer, so it is free of cost available in the net. You can download and burn directly. Okay, it will no require any ISP cable, sub cable, Arduino cable you use. Okay. And you can Wheeler programmer. Okay, this is a universal board. You can use the 8051, 8052 and the Philips that you want. Okay, especially universal keyboard. So we are come back to the PPT. Okay. And this is the our IR sensor. Okay, I also make the by IR sensor a robo. It's an object detector robo. And first of all, I discuss the mic interfacing with the 8051. After that, we are going for Arduino also. Okay, because this robo is working on the Arduino, but this interfacing is based on the 8051. Okay, when the object will detect some object, it gives the signal to the point 0.1, and it's also give to the output. I show you the program. This is the hardware connections I build, and I show the demonstration also. I make a video of this program, and this is the, I write the program. This is the hex file, means it's a register name which found you as a header file, and the S bit A is equal to port 0 0 point, means port 0 key jo aapke 0 pin hai, that's I'm using as a input, and the FF is used for the you are making the port 0 as a output. Okay, as a input. Okay, when you make a input, you show in your program as a FF. If you want to choose as a output of a port, then you use 00. Okay, this is show the hex file, and this is use 00. If you are not used program means if you are show the port as an output, you are no need to define it. If you are not right, P1 is 00, that is, it is no need, means, okay.
The S. Can tell them what is connected at P0.0 and what is connected at P1.0.
Okay.
In your hardware.
Okay.
Accordingly, you can discuss the
same. Okay. S-bit A, port 0, means port 0, 0 pin, it connected as a input, and B, port 1 and 0, it's connected as an output pin.
So, input pe IR sensor laga hai.
Okay. This sensor, this sensor is connected. This is provided by the 5 volt, because it needs, in the figure I show you, it needs the 5 volt for the operating voltage, and it have a ground pin, it's connected to the ground. From the kit, this is a 5 volt and this is the ground connected, and the LED is connected. This is the current limiting resistor connected to the LED. I'll show you the demonstration. Okay.
So basically, when your IR sensor comes, the LED glow will
glow.
The program will spin. We have discussed the C programming. So now in this case, it is interfacing with the IR sensor. The hardware is such that at pin point at port pin P0.0, you have the IR sensor connected, and at port pin P1.0, you have the LED connected. So our logic is that whenever the IR sensor detects some object, the LED should glow. Okay. So the first thing is that in order to make the port 0 as an input port, you have to give right 1 to it. Not necessary that you have to make the whole port high. What you can do is that you can make that particular port pin 0 itself, 1 itself, that will also make the, that particular bit an input bit. But anyways, in this program, what they have done is that they have made this port 0 as an input port, because it is here where the IR sensor is connected, and at port 1, the LED is connected, that is an output mode. So the logic is this while one, I've already told you that this is for continuous repetition. That means you want to repeat this particular process continuously. Okay, so while one, so what we want to compare is if A is nothing but P0.0 equal to 1. You remember yesterday I told you the difference between single equal to and double equal to. If you are putting single equal to, that means you are assigning that particular value. But if you are putting double equal to, that means you are comparing the value. So here we are comparing if port pin 0.0, that means where the IR sensor, it becomes high. That means the IR sensor has detected some object. It will become high because its connections are like that. VCC will be connected to it. So it will detect a high. What action should it take? B should be 1. And what is connected at B? Your LED is connected. So that means whenever the IR sensor detects any object, your LED will glow. If does not, else B should be 0. That means LED should not glow. So that is the logic of the program. Now he will demonstrate this also.
So you can see in the video, this is LED connected to the port 1. 0.0, when we are touch the some object are coming in the front of, when some object are coming in the front of the sensor, LED will be off and LED will be on. Okay, you can see in the video also. Okay, and this is the base, is on the base of IR sensor. I show you this demonstration, how to work it.
So they've made one robot also based on IR sensor.
Actually, we adjust the range and the light is fall on the that, so that's why it's not working. no problem. When I discuss the Arduino, that's why on that time I show you this. So this is the Arduino board. In the Arduino board, this is the USB port to burn the program in the Arduino. Okay, and this is the power port. When you use in external circuit, such as in that circuit, so that's this port is used for providing the power. Okay, when we are programming the power from the laptop, that's why we using this cable. But in the otherwise, we use this cable. This is the power port, and this pin is used for the analog read. So the sensor is coming in the analog pin also, and this is the Atmel microcontroller in the kit, and this one is the serial communications program. Okay, this is LCDR connected to the Arduino also. This one is connected.
LCD.
Okay. All about I told you all the basic connections of LCD, and in this program we use the LCD in the pin number 13 and 11 used as a RS and enable pin, and the other as a data pin. Okay, we use the 4-bit data only, so that's why it's so, and it connected to the Arduino when we are providing the power. Give to the power. So you can see all the data print on the LCD. Okay, this is the programming. I also show the working because the I want water, so that the print on the LCD.
So I want water, it is being displayed there.
Okay, because I want water, I show this lead because I use this sensor to the dumb people have want water and it's not able to say to someone I want water. Okay, making these things easy, so I use the flex sensor and how it is say I want water. So you can use the some speaker also, and when I need water, so he move this finger and the LCD print the I want water. Okay, if he not is he's happy, so no, it's right as a I am happy, and when he want food, so the next finger will be move and the data write I want food. Okay,
so this is for those disabled people who cannot speak. Just by the gestures, if suppose they move the finger forward, they may it may indicate that they need a water. So the LCD, it will display I need water. Suppose he's satisfied, he'll say I'm happy, so he can wave his hand like this. That is why he showed you the flex sensor in the beginning. So the flex sensor, it is sending the signal and the LCD, it is displaying it. So the application may be that his attendant may be at some distance and he may read that thing and then he may come to him. So for such kind of applications, you can develop using this.
Okay, I show you the demonstration. This is my flex sensor, and I make a gloves. I have no gloves, so that's why I using this finger. Okay, I put the sensor here. This is the sensor, and I put sensor here. This sensor in the PPT, it is connected to the when we connected to Arduino and read the value of the sensor, just like a potentiometer, just like a LDR. Okay, so it's vary the speed and it's change the resistance. So LCD print some values. Okay, so we can use these values as an input. When suppose it's less than 200 values, so it's print the I am happy. Okay, when it state it's print the 200. Okay, after that when it's changing the resistance, the value will be changed. So it's print the I am happy. Means what you want to print? Okay, suppose I show you this is a cable and
it's only in one direction.
Yeah, yeah, it's one only. In the starting I told you it's when this side, okay, this side is front. When you bending this side, it is not working. When you bending this one, this side, the resistance will be vary. Okay, in the only one direction. Okay, yeah. Means the resistance potentiometer change the resistance, LDR change the resistance, so that's same working principle, no problem. But see, the principle is bending. Okay, the potentiometer have no bending, LDR is depend on light, so that's why it depend on bending only.
So in this case, the LCD is connected directly to the Arduino. You may also make such an arrangement that at one end you are having the Arduino, and if the attendant is not along with the person, you may send the data wirelessly or maybe through Bluetooth, and there may be some receiver at that end, the LCD is displayed there. So many kind of things they can be done, many applications they can be developed.
And you also control the some motors, okay, from your finger using the RF module. I show though how to make a wireless robo, and from so the RF module you
in
can
such kind of applications where a person is disabled, so you can use these things with a wheelchair. So suppose he wants to move further, he just moves his finger in one direction, the wheelchair will move forward in direction. He may bend it in some other way and it will go in the reverse direction. So it can be used in that ways also. So now he's going to demonstrate the same thing, how by using this flex sensor it will be displaying the things.
Now please can focus on that LCD. Okay, in the screen it is right, I am happy. Okay, when I am folding my finger, I want water. Okay, it's changed the text. Okay, now it's back. So using the okay, the working principle is basic only. You can use as a what you want in the application. You also control the speed of the DC motor from your finger. You connect it to and you vary the resistance and the speed will be controlled. Okay, firing angle will be controlled. It's depend on the application, and you make a robotic arm clone. Okay, making the using the five sensor. Actually, this is the costly sensor. It's 500 rupees only one. Okay, so it's bigger thing when you purchase the five sensor for controlling the five finger, and you make a robotic arm clone hand also, and they have some clone arm, and you can control the arms or the using the stepper motors also. So controlling the five fingers. You use the five stepper motor and making some arrangement. Okay, so you can make a
that's a very interesting application Anurag is discussing. What he said was that in this case he's used only one finger and one flex sensor. Suppose you want to make a clone of your hand. I'm sitting here, okay, and I want to operate something which is at some distance. So what we can do is that just by moving my five this thing flex sensors, I can make a glove here and I could put those five flex sensors here, and my hand's clone will be there. Like whatever movement I'm making with my hand here, the same will be replicated at some distance. So what he said was that you can control stepper motor etc. also with the same thing. Like suppose you want to control something, you would control the movement of something. So just by the gesture here, that is one very interesting application he has discussed.
One time,
with
so you show again. Actually, I fix it.
So he's again demonstrating with the flex sensor.
The display show you. Okay, so it's right. I want food. Okay, and when I'm folding it, I want water. Okay, the text will be changed now. So changing the value of the resistance, we will print the some value. Okay, and what we want, and using I want two display, but only the one finger. Okay, when we are means making a some dictionary, what he want the particular cheese. Okay, so we using the other finger we can make it. Okay. And it is also the principle of this sensor is basically the voltage divider. What is the resistance will be vary, and the voltage change of this flex sensor will be read. Okay, by the and this is also work complete. Okay, so I'm going to the next. This one is a figure. Okay, I show you the video. I make the this project video also. See this video? How can it work? Now I am happier. Okay, I am happy. No, know I want, and when I want something, so I move my finger and it write I want water. Okay, then we are fixed. So it is no problem. It is depend on your application. How can you use this sensor? Now we are going for the next sensor. Okay, in the robotic application, I show you how to make a basic robo and how to make a wireless robo also. So this is the basic block diagram of the wireless robo. It have one transmitter and the one receiver using the RF module. This is the RF module. Okay. So using the RF module, you can make any system wireless. It is used only 4-bit data. 4-bit data will be controlled, means you control the two motors also. The direction of the motor you can control easily, and speed of the motor you can easily control. Okay, this one is the receiver module, the encoder IZ12HTD. I show you the component also, and some push button to controlling the direction. It's forward, reverse, left and right also. And this one is the receiver circuit, and it is ST12ED decoder circuit, and the motor driver L293. And two DC motors are used in my project. And these all the components are required to making a wireless robo. And using this sensor, we also make the smart robo using the flex sensor, using the LDR, IR sensor, object detector. Okay, so we are making this sensor and make a smart robo also. So two DC motors are required, and the IC ST12D, one IC is required. ST12D for encoding the signal, it is decoding the signal. And RF pair, this is the RF pair module I show you, and this is the motor driver L293D, and in 9 volt battery required for giving the power to the motors, and battery connector, some connecting wire, and the robot body, means chassis of the robot, and 7805, I also told 7805 is used to provide the controlling signal, because our power is 9 volt and the controlling signal is 5 volt. So converting the controlling signal to 5 volt, we use this voltage regulator. Okay, and we also use the 750K resistor and 30K resistor, 1K resistor also. So this is my motor driver IC L293D. Using this IC, we control the two DC motors. The speed of the motor is control, direction of the motor is control. Okay, so it have a 16 pin. The pin number 1 and pin number 16 is giving the 5 volt supply, and the motor is connected to the pin number 3. And pin number 3 and pin number 16, pin number 14. Okay, and the pin out 2 output will be connected to the out 3 and the out 4 also. And the pin number 8, it's provide the power supply, the 9 to 12 volt you can provide, and this IC will be work on the 12 volt to 24 volt. Okay, when you are going to the control the higher motor, so you use the other IC L298D. Okay, so it's basic, it's working on the 2 ampere current. When you use the more ampere, controlling the more ampere, so you can go the L2938. Okay, so this is the RF module. It is working on range 433 megahertz frequency, and the output power will be 4 to 16 dBm. Input supply providing the 3 to 12 volt. On the, it have a VCC point and some ground point. Separate power supply to the receiver and the transmitter circuit. This is the circuit diagram of the RF module. Okay, means the transmitter circuit. So it will use the 4 switches for controlling the direction, and it is a battery. This is the voltage regulator. It's convert the 9 volt into the 5 volt, and this antenna, when the signal is encoded, from the encoded bits, 4 bits are coming. It's converting the wireless signal. Okay, and the receiver circuit have also antenna, and it receives the 4-bit data and it's controlling. And it have a 18 pin. All the pin from 1 to 8 will be short, and it is connected to the ground. Okay, and the other pin number 18, it have pin number 18 is giving the 5 volt supply. It is a VCC pin. Pin number 17. Is connected to the data pin, means the 4-bit data, when you connected the 4-bit data provide to the transmitter circuit, and the transmitter circuit will be as a making a wireless signal to the transmitter. Okay, and VSS, all are the grounded, and the transmit module, it have 4 pin. One is the antenna, third one is a VCC pin, third one, and the second one is a data pin, and one pin number one is a ground, because it's use a separate power for provide making the signal, and the four switches are there. Okay, in the next slide, it is a receiver circuit. In the receiver circuit, we use a L298 controlling the power. It is a 12D for decoding the signal, and it has the pin number 1 to pin number 8, all are the short and connected with the ground. In the previous circuit, we also the all are the short and connected with the ground. So in the figure, the 4-bit data, pin number 8, 9, 10, 11, it is a 4-bit data connected. Okay, the signal coming from the switches is AD8, AD9, AD10, AD11. Okay, the 4-bit signal coming in the receiver circuit, D9, D8, D10 or D11. Okay, it receives the signals for decoding, and it is signal sent to the L293D to controlling the motor. It connected to the, here you see, it connected to the pin number 2, pin number 7, pin number 10, and pin number 15 for controlling signal. And the motor will be connected to the 3, 6, one motor is connected, 6 and 11 pin, and the other motor connected, 3 and 14 pin. Okay. And the pin number 8 provide the 9 volt, because we use the 9 volt power to give the motor. And this 9 volt battery using, and this one 9 volt battery is connected to the 7805 to making the controlling signal. Of course, to the 18 pin we provide the 5 volt from, and we provide the 9 volt on the pin number 8, which we use the low potential, means 5 volt and the 9 volt. And this LED is connected pin number 17 to the board, means pin, and if we talk about the receiver circuit, receiver RF module, it have 4 pin also, and it has 4 pin, it's total 8 pin. Okay, so both are grounded, 3 pin number 3 and pin number 2 are grounded, pin number 1 and other pin number 4 is 5 volt VCC. Okay, so it connected to the VCC. Here you can see this one is pin number 1 and this is pin number 4 connected to the VCC. This LED shows, it is blinking, means when your connection is stabilized, so it's blinking, means your connection is fixed, your connection is coming. Okay, and this band, this is stopped, so means that it says it's not working. Okay, and this register is connected to the 15 to 16 pin, 33k. In the last, it is 750k. The 30k register will be connected, the 14 pin will be ground, and the left the pin are ground. Okay, so I will show you demonstration of this project. As I discussed, first we need a body of the robot. So this is the body of a robot. Okay, and we require the 2 DC motor. So these are the 2 DC motor, 2 towers are there. Okay, now we are start to connecting all the things. The first of all, we fix the motor both side, and after that we fix the tire of the motor. Okay, now my body is ready, means you can say the chassis is ready, base of the Bodo robo is ready, and now we are making the controlling circuit, the remote of the robo and the receiver circuit of the robo. So we are started. I also told the basic remote circuit. I also explained all the things of that. So now we are making the robot. This is the same circuit I show you. Using this circuit, we make the remote on the breadboard. So now we are making a complete remote. Now we are going for the receiver circuit. This is a diagram of the receiver circuit. This one. This is L29D and this is STD. This is our RF module. Now we start to make all the things. Now our body is ready and all the remote are ready and the receiver circuit is ready. So we are assembling all the things. These two connected the motor. Means I told you na, two motors are connected. So two controlling signal coming from the smaller receiver circuit. Okay, I connected this and both the motor are connected.
Hello sir. Hello sir, am I audible?
This is the antenna. It receives the signal from the remote and it control the 4-bit data.
Hello sir, am I audible?
And this one and this one, we connected the two battery, two 9-volt battery.
Hello.
No. No, Bobby is complete.
Not here to us.
Now it's time to demonstrate.
So your voice
so now you see how it works. You can make a forward from the switches. You can make a reverse. All the things of controlling of this robo, you can use a Bluetooth module and some other module are available for controlling the wireless signal. Okay, so from this is the our Bluetooth module. This one is our Bluetooth module. So controlling the Android phone, using the Android phone, you can control the all the applications in home, such as light tube light. You can control on and off from your smartphone. And you also in the last lecture, Alokdeep sir is also told how can you take a from real-time sensors, means it show the solar tracker and what is the value of the solar tracker, the voltage, how can it generate it, and it's reading on the smartphone. So using this is the SC05 Bluetooth module, and some other devices are also available such as a Zigbee has controlled the many, means it's not dependent. In the RF module we are required the 4-bit data, but from the Bluetooth module we require the most 10 motor are control easily. It using depend on the apps. Okay, so what is how many sensor will be controlled by the apps. So you use the Bluetooth module, you can control the many things. From Zigbee you can control the Ethernet are also available for the wireless. GSM module is available. So it's depend on the application what you want and what is implemented in your project. So basic things, all the basic things I show you. And this one, this is my maker small. Chala light adjusted. So this is IR based robo, means when the some object are coming in the front of the sensor, it will be stopped. Okay, so this is the, you see that when the some object are coming, so it will be stopped. Now it running condition you call. Okay, it's running. To show very clearly. You can adjust the range of this is our potential, so you can change the range of the distance, how means how much distance you take and it will be stopped. Okay,
sensor laga band kar gaya, dekho ye line follower hai. Aa jao neha, main udhar aa
jao.
Aa jao
ek mat budak char baithe.
I make a switch here and I also discuss in this. So we use in this robo two DC motor here. One motor is this, one motor is this, two tire are there. This is our Arduino board. This pin is used as an input pin. when the some object are detected by the sensor.
Line follower wala.
When the some object detected by the sensor, it's giving the signal to pin number. Pin number 9. Okay, and we connected a transistor circuit to this model for providing the switching transistor circuit with a resistor, such as it provide the controlling signal when we get giving the gate pulse. When we giving the base power on the base, transistor will be on and it will be giving the controlling signal to the motors. Okay, so in the 9 volt battery is connected here also. Just show you the 9 volt battery for providing the power to the both motors. And the both motors are connected in the parallel because when giving the power, it's going in the one direction, forward and the reverse. And when the sensor, this is the sensor, and when it detect, this is the detector in the sensor, this one is a receiver and this one is a transmitter. Okay, this one is making a signal and it to attack to the object and receive the this signal. This is the photodiode and this is a simple LED. Okay, to making these things, we are also developed on the breadboard also, we are making this sensor on, okay, using this sensor, this IC, this IC need, and making the use of some resistors and the capacitor, we can develop this, so these sensors. Okay, and the sensor is coming. So when the signal is coming from this point, I make a program of the sensor. And the in the last lecture, Alok sir is also discussed how can blinking LED from the Arduino and all the basic things. Okay, so when we fix this pin as an input, and it is a digital signal coming from those, we are not required to connect it in the analog side. Okay, so we are using in the digital side also. Okay, when it is the analog signal, on the analog signal, that's why we are connected to the analog pins only. Okay, such as this is analog signal. When we connected this, we also connected in the analog pin. And this is the LDR sensor. When I connected this, it is also connected to the LDR, means the analog pin sensor also. Okay, so when this one is high, it's given to the signal to pin number 10, and pin number 10 is the base of the transistor. When the we give the power to the base of the transistor, the switching will be on, and the motor power get to the motor, and your motor will be going to forward. Okay, so I told the all the basic things from this, and I also making the switches here, and this is the switch to controlling the manually control to the motor. When we open the on it, and it's working. Okay, it's now working, and it is stop. Okay, and this power is used when we use the Arduino as a programmer. So this cable, the Arduino cable, programmer cable will be used. But when we is a dedicated application, so that's why we need a power source. So and this 9 volt battery giving the power to this Arduino 9 volt power. And using this cable, we can fix it and using in some applications also. Okay. Okay.
Can you check with the
yeah, no problem.
Robot for the transfer, like a glass, if there is object like a glass.
Yeah.
Then
means actually it depends on the object. If your signal is transmitted, means it's a distance. You vary the range, na? Okay, if you suppose these type of things, if the range is transmit, okay, so there are no, it's detect, there are no object. Okay, means you make a arrangement, it is a potentiometer, na? So you make arrangement first to check at the arrangement, then you use. Okay, and it is, I also told that it is a 30 centimeter only. When you use a larger, that you use the other sensor also.
Is a transparent object.
Yeah, I understand you. What do you say? This is the transparent object. Suppose this is the transparent object.
Okay.
It's a way go to high, na, and it's no detector. It is there are no object. It is going on. Okay. Actually, it's depend totally depend on the this. And this when you use the this sensor in the front of robot, when I make on the this sensor replacing this sensor, it will be work. Means it's a distance. When I make a distance, suppose I make a program in the Arduino to going the 10 centimeter and come back. So how can calculate the time by the this ultrasonic sensor? It's give the and how many take 10 is calculate the distance and it's come back. Okay, so all the sensor I discussed, and there are many other sensor are available in the market. So using this sensor, we are making the smart applications in the robotic also, home automations, door automatic open, you also see in the markets also and mall also, and you going to door will be open automatically. Okay, so using these sensor we are making the many things. So I discuss the basic things. If you have any query, I am happy to answer your queries.
Let us ask.
Is the total number of sensors available, or you have just discussed important ones?
Means,
there are many sensors.
There are many sensors, ma'am. Just a few ones. Means, using these sensors, means if I using five sensors or five IR sensor, we are making the line follower robot. Okay, it's detecting a one color. Next robot means the next sensor. If I use this sensor, okay, making the arrangement of the sensor, we can make many things. When we are develop a line follower robot, so we require the five IR sensor and fix it. And this sensor is follow the black line only. And there are black line. He detect the black line. It's giving the signal. Okay. So making the arrangement of the sensor, so it's will.
Let us contact the sensors.
Robots are there which are sensing the light and
body. Yeah. So it depend on the sensor which you application you use.
First sensor.
You have any query?
Madurai. Anna University Regional Center, Madurai. Any doubts you have?
Where will be the answer thing?
Yes, do you have any doubts? Yes or no?
Yeah. No, we don't have doubts. Is there any hands-on training? Is there any hands-on training in this zone?
स्पीकर बंद
किया है
Yes, sir.
Is there any hands-on training?
Yeah, we have some teachers are there in a innovative skill. In the last lecture, you are met with the Alok Deep. So we are making the team and provide a hands-on training also in the NITR in the innovative skill. If you want to take a hands-on practice, you can come. And we are providing a workshop in your institute also.
You are interested in coming here, or you want them to come to your place?
No, I'm asking, is there any hands-on training regarding this one? Because you are showing the demo only.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
You are showing the demo only. That's why I'm asking, is there any hands-on training in this program? In this Friday's?
Sir, this is an ICT-based course. How is hands-on training possible? In case you are interested in doing hands-on training possible, hands-on training, there is one course, STC Contact Mode Program, in the month of July. You're most welcome to come here in NITR and do the hands-on.
Yeah, okay. Thank you.
The ICT mode, we can only show that demo, na? Or how will you do hands-on at your place?
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
So please move to the next center. RTU Kota.
Am I audible, ma'am?
Yes, sir. We can hear you.
My question to sir. Yesterday we have discussed about programming of Arduino with the help of MATLAB.
Yeah.
Is there any ready-made module is available for 8051 programming with MATLAB?
Actually, Arduino is friendly with the MATLAB. Okay, you making some program on the fuzzy logic based, ANN based, because when we are training to the robo, when suppose we are making a develop robo, so you can make the your rules in the fuzzy logic using the ANN tools also and the fuzzy tools also. So you making the MATLAB file and it's easy to interface with the Arduino. Okay, Arduino is friendly, but it's difficult to connect with the 8051. So this is
that is why we have discussed the various programming languages, which are used for 8051. For that, the most widely used one is embedded C only.
So this is the problem with the 8051. When you use your applications, so you use the Arduino also. I also help to you with the interfacing of the MATLAB. no problem. It's when you make a fuzzy loading model and what you want in the MATLAB, it's also connected with that.
Okay, thank you, sir. For engineers from electrical engineering stream, it is not possible to learn C language.
Yeah.
Complex C programming for 8051 microcontrollers. That's sir, why I am asking this.
Person, don't say that. I'm a core electrical person. I've been doing embedded systems since last 10 years. It's not, there is nothing like that, that electrical people cannot do C programming.
Actually, just for example, in MATLAB, we design, we model, we make a model in Simulink, means we go for model based designing and the code the code is automatically generated by MATLAB itself.
I told you, sir, is the easy way of the Arduino programming. Okay, but first you try it. There are some software are there, mBlock. Okay, you are no need to write your program. You just take a block and you also you write a program. You just take a block and paste on the your screen, and using these blocks you can make your program. You are no need to read deeply the C programming also.
No. Actually, what he's saying is that for Arduino it is possible. Yeah. So if such kind of thing is possible for 8051 also. This is his question.
Okay.
For 8051, you'll have to learn C. Any other questions, sir? Any other? Okay, next.
One more question, ma'am.
Anji. Yes, sir.
Sir, can you explain the LCD code for that you used?
Actually, this is I show you.
Sir, LCD, on Thursday in the morning also I told. On Thursday in lecture, I will tell you the whole interfacing part along with the C code also. Thursday morning lecture.
Good morning.
Thank you.
Okay. CIT? Surendra Group? Yes, ma'am. Any doubts?
No, ma'am. No doubts.
Okay. Thank you. CIT? Panipat Institute?
Hello.
Yes, sir.
My question is how do you train your ultrasonic sensor?
This one is the ultrasonic sensor. Just a minute.
How can set the range of ultrasonic sensor? How can set the range?
How to set the range? That is the question.
Actually, this is the ultrasonic sensor. Without changing the range, but many sensor, ultrasonic sensors are available in the market with the fixing the range. You can check on the online also, the means arrangement of the range, you can purchase from the online also. Okay, but this sensor is not changing the range. This one is not changing that. This range is fixed. This is a 400 centimeter. I told in the when I show the PPT, in the PPT I show you this range is 30 centimeter to 400 centimeter only.
In market there is any manual sensor, sir?
Yes, sir. What is your question?
In market there is any manual sensor, sir? Manual. We can change the range of ultrasonic.
There is
only fixed sensor.
Manual available.
Means, sir, I told na this is IR sensor. You can make one. Means
he is asking ki inke saath kuch manual bhi aata hai
kya? Yeah, no, manual.
Manual.
This is no manual, but all the working of this sensor are available on the net. Na, how can you use? It have only 4 pins. In this sensor, there are 2 pins. 2 pins are using for the giving the power to the sensor. One is for analog read. One is for the digital read. Okay, the sensor have a 2 reads. The digital when your signal is analog form, when your signal is digital form. So you can take it the input only. So this is no manual are there because it's giving the power and take the input only.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome.
Okay, thank you so much, Mr. Anurag and Mr. Chandan. They have explained the various sensors like ultrasonic sensor, IR sensor, flex sensor, and which other sensor have you discussed?
PIR
sensor also. Then he showed you some applications based on 8051 as well as Arduino programming, and wherein LCD interfacing was done. Then one wireless robot also you can design using these sensors. And in the Thursday's lecture, I'll show you like today we have seen how to convert the C hex file from from the C file. On Thursday's lecture, I will tell you how to actually burn into the microcontroller. And some interfacings are also pending. For example, LCD interfacing, its C code, etc. All these things I will be demonstrating to you on Thursday lecture. So thank you so much, both of you.